Right, friends, it's been such a long time. I'm doing a quick little update on my gumbo recipe. I've switched up a few things, so I just wanted to update y'all. Of course, we're starting with the basics. I like to put in a little yellow onion. I do red bell pepper that's not pictured, and I did about 3 stalks of celery, and I minced up about probably 6 to 7 cloves of garlic. And you just want to dice everything up really, really well. Y'all, there were a lot of casualties that happened during the recording of this, so bear with me. It is absolutely not perfect, but again, it's more of a refresher course. You can always go back to my first gumbo video to get, you know, if you need a more thorough step-by-step. Okay, so next up, I am making my roux. I started off with about 3/4 cup of canola oil. You can use vegetable oil or canola oil, really whatever your preference is. And I'm stirring in about 1 cup of all-purpose flour. And I'm just going to kind of take you through the stages of color with the roux to show you how dark you need to get it for the perfect gumbo. I'm a pro at this, so I cook my roux on like a medium heat. If you're more of a beginner or if you're a little scared and not sure, you want to start on probably a low heat. Now, this can take anywhere from 30 minutes to an hour for this whole process. You see, you got like more of a milk chocolate here. You want to go further. This is more of the color that you want to stop at, that dark, dark chocolate. You want to get it right before the stage, before it's burnt. So I'm tossing in all of my veggies, minus the garlic, just my onion, celery, and bell pepper. I actually burned myself right here, y'all. I got a good second degree burn that is really ugly right now. But I'm stirring in my vegetables, and I'm gonna let them saute on this medium low heat. I turned the heat down slightly. I'm gonna let it simmer for about 5 minutes. Just let it do its own thing. Stir it real good, but be careful, y'all. This roux, it's hot. And when I say it's dangerous, making gumbo can be dangerous. All right, after 5 minutes, I'm gonna toss in my garlic. Again, use how much garlic you want. I like about 5-6 cloves, because I'm also gonna add some, there's garlic powder in my Cajun seasoning. And I'm gonna let that cook for about anywhere from 30 seconds to 1 minute. You don't need to go crazy. You just wanna kinda get it fragrant. As soon as you smell it, go ahead and add in your tomato paste. This is optional. I love like that tomato kind of flavor. I put about 2 tablespoons, as you see here. I started with 1 and then was like, well, what the heck? Let's go ahead and add in a 2nd tablespoon. So you just want to stir this in really, really good into your roux. I'm about to toss in the 2nd. Like, it may not even be a full tablespoon. Y'all, if you've been here a while, you know I let the spirit guide me. I don't really follow strict measurements when it comes to my recipes. I'm going to add in my stock now. I'm adding in 1/2 chicken stock, 1/2 seafood stock that I just made using some leftover frozen, like, various seafood shells that I've saved. And I like to add it in slowly. I find that it's less likely for my roux to kind of break up. And just it gives you more to have to skim off at the end of the process. So I add my stock in pretty slowly, and I stir it simultaneously. It just turns out the best this way. You want your food to taste good, but you also want to do your best to make it look good also. And this is just gives me the best results. Next up, I'm going to season it up. Like I said, I do a all-purpose Cajun seasoning that I make. Threw in some extra red pepper flakes because I love spicy food. Not shown here, y'all. I do throw in at that time a bay leaf, about 3 fresh bay leaves, as well as my sausage for my gumbo. And that's just to add extra flavor. I like to let my gumbo cook right here. Let me tell y'all what I'm doing. I'm just skimming off the extra fat. Back to what I was saying. I like to let my gumbo cook for about 1 to 1.5 hours before I start adding in my seafood. Because I usually don't make, you know, chicken gumbo too often. I just like to do... Everyone loves seafood in my house, and that way everyone gets to eat the gumbo without picking out a bunch of different foods. So that's what we're doing here. I'm just skimming off the extra fat. Again, it's not going to harm anyone if you keep it there. But we want our food to look good, just like we want it to taste good. So I do that. And then I also added in my lump crab. Because we don't have blue crabs just readily available here, I like to throw in 1 to 2 cans of jumbo lump crab in my mix. Now I'm gonna also add some snow crab legs. I just break them up and throw that in the mix. I'm also gonna throw in a little seafood melody of about 6 lobster tails, probably about like 1.5 to 2 pounds of colossal shrimp. They said it was colossal, but y'all, it didn't look very colossal to me. But you can add what you like. This is your seafood gumbo or your gumbo. You can add chicken to the mix. You can add any kind of sausage. You can add oysters. Normally, I would add oysters because we love them in my house, but my grocery store was out of them. So I just rolled with what I had. And I let this cook for about an additional, you know, seafood doesn't take long, probably about 10 minutes. You don't have to add the crab legs. I just want to say that it's really good to suck out the juices, though, from your gumbo and eat the crab at the same time. Now, I added in my okra last because it's frozen okra. It doesn't take long at all to cook. And it also serves as a thickening agent. And I'm adding in about 1/2 tablespoon of gumbo filet. It's also a thickening agent, but it also gives like a really yummy and unique flavor to your gumbo. And I'm just going to let that cook for about an additional 10 more minutes until it's done. And then voila. And y'all know the ultimate Black people seasoning is topping it with some parsley. Normally I would do scallions, but I didn't have any. So here we are.